Magneto, I'm disappointed in you, man. You're one of the most powerful mutants to ever live, and yet, you could be so much more powerful if you simply looked into the science of your own superpowers. You can do more than levitate and pull iron out of abusive security guards' blood. Here are 7 superpowers that you may not have thought of. Magneto was created all the way back in 1963 by Stan Lee and Jack Kirby as Max Eisenhart, a human mutant with the ability to generate and manipulate magnetic fields. Now, unless you avidly read X-Men comics, most of what you've seen Magneto do is move metals around and levitate. But if Magneto can manipulate magnetic fields, he has way more superpowers than just those. But first, magnetism. How does that work? Magnetism is a part of electromagnetism, one of the 4 fundamental forces of the universe. This force binds electricity and magnetism together such that changing an electric field creates a magnetic field as described by Ampere's law, and changing a magnetic field induces an electric field as described by Faraday's law of induction. Now, what about magnets? How do they work? Down at the quantum scale, the motion of tiny charged particles like electrons creates tiny magnetic fields. The two are linked, remember, so just about all matter that you know of is intrinsically magnetic, just of varying intensities. So for example, this marker is what we call diamagnetic. In the presence of a magnetic field, its tiny particles create a magnetic field that opposes the magnetic field it's inside. We consider these kind of materials to be non-magnetic. On the other hand, if you take a ferromagnetic material like this piece of iron, in the presence of a magnetic field, all of its tiny magnets align to create the kind of magnet that you're used to. What Magneto can do in the comic books and movies and TV shows is then based on the link between electricity and magnetism and the interaction of these forces and fields with materials. What he can do is impressive and even kind of sciencey, but now that we know the basis for his superpowers, we can give him even more. My desk toy! So here are 7 other superpowers that Magneto gets simply from being the master of magnetism. Magneto is always moving so slow, and that's because he has to use a ton of power to levitate over non-magnetic stuff. That is possible if you use a crap ton of magnetic fields like this frog is experiencing, but there is a way he can travel much, much faster. Magneto could go to any pair of train tracks in the world and start running. Then at some speed, according to Lenz's law and depending on the magnetic field underneath him, he would begin to levitate like a magnetically levitated train. Then he could create alternating magnetic fields on the sides of him to accelerate him up to hundreds of kilometers per hour. If Magneto got clever, he could put iron filings in thousands of pounds of putty. Then, as in this video, he could use his magnetic fields and powers to animate that mass and make it a nearly indestructible sticky golem beast. Having a power over magnetism is really a power over electromagnetism and electromagnetic radiation, like visible light. So using his magnetic fields, Magneto could bend light around himself to become invisible whenever he wanted. Oh no! As we've learned, an electric field can create a magnetic field and vice versa. So, facing a metallic enemy like Colossus or Wolverine, Magneto could apply a huge magnetic field around them, which would induce an electric current to flow through one of these guys. Electric currents tend to make stuff hotter when they flow through something, so at some point, as in this video, the metal would melt, meaning that Wolverine's bones would turn straight into goo. Remember that one time Magneto ripped all the adamantium out of Wolverine's body? Pretty cool. Literally boiling Wolverine's skin off because his bones are melting? Even cooler. If Magneto's magnetic fields were strong enough, he could use them to force atoms so close together that they actually fused and released huge amounts of energy. We try to do the same thing with magnetic fields in experimental fusion reactors like you're seeing in this video. So, Magneto could single-handedly end the energy crisis. Or, and stick with me here, this gets a little complicated. Technically, Magneto could create lightsaber! The end of the world may come in the form of a gamma ray burst, or a meteor strike, or global warming, or it could happen after humanity is plunged into chaos following the loss of all of the world's electronics. If Magneto used every ounce of his powers, he may be able to disrupt the plasma flowing along the intense magnetic field lines of the sun. If he could, then Magneto could send a solar flare directly at Earth, with charged particles screaming at a million miles per hour, impacting all of the world's electronics and creating electric currents inside of them to fry them and send us back to the Stone Age. This is to scale.
Hey, I just forgot all of X-Men The Last Stand. Nice.
Everything that you are, every thought you have, every desire, every personality quirk that makes you you, is more or less the result of a storm of electrical signals thundering around the neurons of your brain. And as we've learned, magnetic fields can alter electrical signals. So, magnetic fields can mess with your mind. And we know this to be true because we've studied it. It's called transcranial magnetic stimulation, and it can move your limbs without you willing them to do so, as you're seeing in this video. We've also found that it can alter your brain chemistry and help fight depression. And it can turn off the parts of your brain that reason morally. This is, in theory, complete control over body and mind, a power at least as strong as Charles Xavier's powers, and Magneto has it. So, according to science, Magneto should be able to do way more than just move metal and levitate. He could travel like a high-speed train. He could melt Wolverine from the inside out. He could control your mind, and he could end the world. Seems that Max is even more powerful than we thought. Because science. You can't see it, but I'm levitating. I assure you. Thank you so much for watching. Follow me on Twitter at SciFile to suggest ideas for future episodes, on Instagram where I'm now posting extra mini episodes of Because Science, and if you have any more sciencey superpowers for Magneto, put them in the comments below. Now, this Saturday, shameless plug, I am hosting the new Mythbusters show called Mythbusters The Search. It airs Saturdays on the Science Channel. You can catch the second episode this Saturday. There's explosions. What's incredible about magnetism, if you think about it, is that it cannot be fully understood without quantum mechanics. So when you see a magnet, it's only responding to magnetic forces and attracting other things because of quantum mechanics. This doesn't happen in everyday life. We don't get to see how the universe works at the smallest scales. But things are only magnetic because charged particles are moving around at the quantum scale, and those line up with each other in the orbitals of atoms in just the right way so they don't cancel out, and then those atoms all line up the right way in regions of materials, and then regions of materials all line up the right way to produce strong magnetic fields that we can notice at our scale. Magnetism is a window into the fabric of the universe, into how it really works, and all of that you can get from a refrigerator magnet.